Hi everybody, welcome to Brick Vault. It's Mike here and welcome to our weekly top 10 mocks video where I'm showing my favorite mocks of last week. Also, I'm showing your fan creations that you guys are sending to our Brick Vault fan mocks email. There's gonna be a link below and all the rules. And also, I want to take the chance to mention our awesome mock store, brickvault.toys, www.brickvault.toys on the screen. If you wanna check those out, you can find awesome ties and Batmobiles and we more mocks to come. We're expanding our base. So I hope you're gonna enjoy them, and that is also a great way to support our channel if you want to. Thanks so much for doing that, and now let's jump into this first mock.
As every week, guys, all the links to those awesome creations I'm showing in this episode can be found in the video description below. And starting off with number 10 this week, we have some micro builds from Chris Perron, and those are hitting the nostalgia notes just right. I actually have two builds for you. The first one, the most recent one, is the Ice Penguin Excursion. That is a take on the Ice Planet 2002 theme, one of the most favorite ones amongst the fans, just with that nostalgia feeling to it. And that is not based on any of the sets that were released, but somewhat of a different take on the lore. As Chris is describing, this vehicle is meant to take up to 6 penguins on a short tour of the ice planet to help, well, familiarize them with the surroundings. Apparently, traveling with bigger groups of penguins resulted in those being very distracted by each other and interrupting their learning of the planet. I guess now the ice planet explorers are recruiting penguins for training purposes and to be effective members of their teams. Awesome take on the lore. I like the build for this icy surface. The vehicle with some sleds in the front and some pointy wheels in the back is looking really good. I like the use of the canopy piece on the side for this massive side window and a small trained penguin on the side, I think, that's guarding the post. Really fun take on one of my favorite space themes of all time, but Chris did not make only this one last week. He also posted the new build for the Space Police, funny enough that we just did a collection review on the old Space Police minifigures, and he built something called the Space Police 2 Enforcer. Amazing looking ship, studless in design and quite sleek looking. If you wanna check out all those pictures in quite high resolution, I'm gonna link, of course, Chris's Flickr account right below. Moving up to number 9, we have another sci-fi build, a craft from Tastenman 77. This is Interstellar D-17, and it is something that looks like a baby of an X-Wing and Viper from Battlestar Galactica. This was an entry for the Rogu contest, Deep Space Discovery, on rogubricks.de in Germany, and I do like this hybrid of those very iconic crafts from two different, completely different sci-fi lores, as pretty much all the design points work great from both of them. The canopy seems to be like from an X-Wing, the wings obviously, but the whole bulkiness of it seems to be going from the Viper. A studless build which I always appreciate, a nice selection of minifigures and additional equipment that make this a complete sci-fi build. Also like the color combo with just white contrasting with orange and dark grey, that always works great. Quite a fun build, and I always like to see different takes on the popular themes that seem to be introducing something entirely new. Alright, let's jump up to number 8. This is the builder Jaifa with his mech Shin Calibur Arturios. That is basically your weekly mech of the week. I always like to choose one at least for my videos. And this style of building reminds me of course the Japanese mecha. He's mostly wielding melee weapons, so we don't really see any ranged weaponry on this guy. And the style of building is really connecting to that Japanese lore. I love the coral concept of blue, which is my favorite color by the way, and white for the torso and the sword. There is some sort of a shield with some orange elements onto it, and overall you can also see the wide use of those slow pieces in blue that make the build pretty much completely studless, with a very few exceptions. I believe this thing has also flight capability with those wings in the back, or some sort of a jetpack, maybe that's what it is. A few stickers here and there complement the build, and overall the posability and the playability seems to be top notch. That is not the first mecha we featured from this builder, check out his Flickr page if you want to see more. And continuing with the sci-fi this week, so many good mocks in this vibe, we have number 7 from Joe Perez, and that is the Vintage Tron Light Cycle. Funny thing is that this episode is coming actually on the day of launch of the official Tron Cycle LEGO Ideas set from Brick Bros UK, and here we have quite a bigger version of this very unique vehicle. Actually, the whole presentation of this mock looks like a good 80s vibe poster. I especially love the wavy hair of the model. Those parts work great for this style of photography and display. And the pose and the bike in the back really scream 80s in this one. Very sleek looking build, as all the light cycles were in Tron. And I like this rough but still good looking technique on the buildable figure. Joe even named the vehicle with exact model, that is Ancom 786 vintage light cycle. So I think it's connecting more to the first classic Tron movie rather than the latest one, The Legacy. Quite an awesome stuff and really connecting with the movie. Alright, enough sci-fi. Number 6 is something, well, a bit different but still a bit eerie, if I may. This is The House of the Inventor by Philip Olin. And by eerie, I say the atmosphere around this building is quite horror-esque, if there's even a word for that. That is a modular building, seems to be fitting on one base plate, so fits any city you want, including ours, that would be great to have. And not only we have amazing details for the street outside of the House of the Inventor, but the interiors are really striking, literally. The cellar has some crazy, very scary elements to it, with some radioactive equipment and some crazy scientists working there. The main hallway has the Frankenstein's head, I think, in a glass dome for display. That is really creepy but awesome looking at the same time. You can also take a look at the entrance with this amazing staircase leading to this weird old rusty door. And right at the top floor beneath the roof, there is a secret lab with Frankenstein monster being brought to life. The roof is finalizing this build with some awesome antennas for catching thunders, obviously. And overall, this thing is packed with details, has this great atmosphere. I highly recommend you to check out the Flickr page to see all the high-res photos. Alright, halfway there, moving up to number 5, we have the comeback of the classic Space with the Neo touch to it, of course. Quite a popular theme among mock builders, this is Benny's Space Cruiser from Roland Smith, and Benny is always packing a style in his ride, this time is no different. I like the simple shape of the ship that touches really well with the classic Space Lego building, which was not very detailed, but with added gribbling and a nice use, of course, of the contrast of blue and gray, we have an excellent ship right here. I love the oversized engine in the back and a lot of pointy wings to make up the shape. Benny has quite a functioning cockpit and never-ending smiling face, obviously. And there's generally a bunch of cool things about this smog that you just have to see yourself. I guess I will never be bored of the neo-classic space builds, especially from talented builders like that. This is another great example of this awesome lore. Moving up to number 4, this is another great build from Bridos Bricks, the Daredevil Red Rod, a car that strikes visually and I guess it's quite powerful. A lot of chrome pieces used here for this great effect. The whole seating area is built marvelously with silver pedals and the shifter, and all this stuff just looks amazing. I don't really mind custom chrome pieces as long as they provide the effect as such. And basically the hot rod looks like something you would love to see on some sort of a car trade show or any other display. That would for sure turn some eyeballs. Amazing photography goes along with this model, so make sure to go to the Flickr page of Bridos Bricks and check those out yourself. Alright, the best of the best, top 3. With number 3, I have a biased choice because I love this game. This is a build from StarCraft 2. It comes from David Frank, and this is basically an entire StarCraft map built with 3 different races, the Zerg, the Protoss, and the Terran. This is the map Megaton from StarCraft 2, and as a designer mentions in his description, this is not the complete build. I think he's gonna expand with more units, more buildings, and more map area. So far, we have the main buildings and some units from each of the races, and as I played StarCraft and StarCraft 2 a lot, I recognize every single one of them, many of you may as well. So we have Zerg base with Hydralisks and their drones mining the minerals. There is an Overlord. The higher ground is taken by Terrans with their command center and the siege tanks. You can also see the SCVs, the barracks, and some marines along the way. I think they also have an expansion base in the upper right corner and fighting the Protoss, which are holding the spot on the left upper corner. The Protoss have the Nexus, the Zealots, there is I think the Colossi, the Warp Gate, all of those units are available and seen in this great mod. And generally I cannot wait for an expansion for this one because this looks great. Quite a fantastic StarCraft display, especially pleasing for the fans of the game like myself. And moving on with number 2, we have the very Easter build, because pretty much this episode is published on Easter. Happy Easter, everyone. This is the never disappointing JK Brickworks Jason with his, well, egg pooping bunny. And of course the bunny moves and works as described. I'm gonna leave a link to the video from Jason right below. I'm not gonna spoil it to you too much, you gotta witness it yourself. The build works amazingly good and just Jason's builds never cease to amaze me. Great build for Easter, Jason, I really appreciate your effort and I hope you guys will feel the same. And moving up to number one, I chose something I was actually missing kind of for the last few episodes. By that I mean an enormous build of a diorama in medieval times. And this one here is coming from LEGO Lord. This is the Downwood Castle. A massive diorama, I'm not sure how big this is. And this is, I think, a collaborative build between different builders. So there's everything on the Flickr page if you wanna check out who was behind it. And the amazing display features the forest area, the outskirts of the castle, with some amazing medieval homes, towers, I think there's a church, and the castle itself is featuring a number of towers as well, an amazing gribbling on the sides of the castle with different colors to show the withering of the stone. Also a different shout out goes to the trees along the castle, different styles, colors and builds, I think they do come from different builders. And the whole build is accompanied by amazing photography with a lot of details, I think there's even a dragon in there somewhere. So not to spoil too much, I highly recommend you guys to check out the Flickr page with all the amazing shots of this beautiful mock. There's even a mini version, a microscale build of this guy to complement the whole amazing thing. So congrats on such achievement, I always appreciate such mocks and I always appreciate the time and effort that you guys are putting into them. Alright, and that would be it for this week's top 10 mocks. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed my selection and I always appreciate your comments as every week. And now it is time to show your fan creations that you guys are submitting to our Brick Vault fan mocks email. If you want to submit more for next week, the rules are below. So thanks guys again for watching. If you enjoyed this episode, you can always leave a like and subscribe. It was Mike here at Brick Vault. Let's cue the music and show off your mocks.